nice French Lee's got itself a trot mooring. It's on a swinging mooring and going aground all the time. It's really nice. It's a coume de mer. Like the French sailor, French chap who's got the YouTube video. Oh my god, it's black calm today. I'm going to stop and get the dinghy out, really. It's going to be in the way for fishing, and it's a bit of a strain on the dinghy to be towing it, so I'd rather not if I can help it. Well, this is very bloody nice. Lovely bit of sailing. I mean, we're not wrecking along or anything, but it's a gorgeous day for it. And every once in a while you get a nice little gust and she picks up her skirts. And then the tiller pilot can't handle it, that'll take over. I've got to get that tiller pilot mounted further back. It just doesn't have enough purchase on the tiller, enough throw. But it's gorgeous. You can see Lou down there. That's the headland of Foy. We're headed over to Falmouth. Absolutely cracking thing. Beautiful. Sails are looking nice. It's all good. Well, the sea breezes have got up some, and then the Coriolis effect has spun it round, so it's no longer headed straight for the land. It's now spun round to the southwest, and I'm going straight into the wind. So I've taken the sails down, and I'm motoring, which feels a little bit like defeat. But I've still got 6 hours if I'm motoring straight at it. If I was sailing and beating towards windward, I probably wouldn't get in till 10, 11 at night if I was lucky. So unfortunately, the motor it is. So, as I said, it's just gone one and we're motoring, and I think that must be Polpero on our starboard bow there. Lovely, pretty little Polpero. It's still a pretty lovely day, mind. Here's the conditions approaching Dodman Point. It's pretty blowy. I've got my bloody smock on. It's a bit chilly. Well, it's 20 past three. And we've still got the wind on the nose. but we're Dodman Point's up ahead, and I can see Mevagizzy, and I think I can see Falmouth in the distance. We've got about 3.5-4 hours to go. Let's have a quick look around. Dodman Point. Been up ahead of us basically forever. It doesn't get close very quick. Coming around the Dodman so that we're here, it's pretty much slack tide now, which will be good because when the tide turns it's going to be going out high tide now, so the tide will be ebbing, and with the wind as it is, which I didn't think it was going to be, so I didn't think it was going to be an issue, but it's all worked out well because with the wind on the nose like this we're going to have wind against tide, might pull it up into a little bit of a chop round the Dodman, but luckily we're going round there before the tide really gets running, and it's neaps anyway, so it's not a huge deal, but it should make the trip round the Dodman as comfortable as possible. Past four now, and I'm still not round the Dodman Point. Oh, the Dodman Point! I'm getting a bit bored of the Dodman Point. It's only 2.5-3 hours to go. I think we've picked up speed a bit over ground. Got a bit of tide behind us now, and the waves have dropped off, and the headwind has dropped off a bit, and it's sort of it's turning into that evening glass off. You know, it's that calm 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock period that happens on the coast, which is really nice. So I'll give you a look around, show you the Dodman up a bit even closer. Well, here we go, there's the Dodman over there. Ever changeable today. Now they've swung round and they're coming back off the shore again. And that's Falmouth Head that we're pointing for, and they're going along under sail, doing a good 5 knots. So lovely, lovely way to end the day. I don't think we're going to be able to sail up into Falmouth though if the wind stays in this direction. But we should be able to make it, you know, off in Dennis Head there. Get the sails down and motor up into Falmouth. And then there's the small matter of trying to find somewhere to stay for the night. Sounds like the anchorage is really busy. And there's a ferry coming in tonight at some ungodly hour, 3 in the morning or something. So you really don't want to be in the way of that. we've got about another hour to come off Falmouth. Probably about another hour, I think. There's a lovely old gaffer up there, isn't he? I've had an absolutely stonking sail for the last hour. It's been really... You know, I had a reef in the main, a reef in the jib, and I've still been going along at between 5 and 6 knots. Pretty gusty, so when a gust hits, I'd have to round up a bit and let the main out. It's pretty, pretty tiring sailing. So it's blowing a hoolie out of Falmouth. Hopefully I'm going to be able to find somewhere sheltered for the night. I really hope so. I'm tempted to head off up towards Smugglers, you know, up the river more and find some shelter. If the anchorage in here looks a bit shit, or if there's not much space. But there's still a load of boats racing around, tear-arsing, so I'd take the sails down because I'm not the most manoeuvrable or fleet of boats. I'd hate to get caught up in a race and have people shouting at me for getting in the way and ruining a good race. Still blowing really strong. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it. You can't see the wind from this, but it's certainly rattling the rigging. That's really helping over there. iPhone does its best to cut it out. There we go, so what's the time now? It's 10 to 7. Not too bad. About 10 hours from Plymouth down to Falmouth. Oh god, I hope I can find somewhere nice for the night. Not many of the boats have got 0.7 of a metre draft. There's all the marina, well, all the alongside Falmouth Classic boats. And then it's a bit close, this anchorage. Everything's a bit close. I'm going to have to keep a good watch as the tide turns. I shall set the alarm and get up for that. And there we go. Any out further out there, apparently I rang up the marina or the harbour master on my way in. I'm not sure if my VHF's working. I know you said yours was dodgy, but I didn't hear anything on the way in, and I called a marina and no one answered, but then it might be, I think they're only on there till 5 o'clock or something, I don't know. Anyway, but over there, I think there's a ferry coming in there at 4 in the morning. She said if you're too far out on this anchorage, you're gonna get woken up and asked to move. So I thought, right, I'm gonna get right on the inside. I'd rather fight with the wall and other boats than a fucking great big ferry. But yeah, it's a nice little anchorage. It's sheltered anyway. The further out was definitely breezier. I think the wind's dropped off a bit now anyway, but I'm sure all those boats' masts and all the flags and everything must be soaking up some breeze. So here we are in Falmouth, finally anchored up and managed to find somewhere. I'm going to be a little bit nervous here overnight because there's not a lot of room to swing, and when the tide turns and everything, I'm not sure what's going to happen. So I shall probably set an alarm and get up. I've not got an awful lot of space, but then beggars can't be choosers. That's the way it is. There's my nearest neighbour, Aeolus of Mylor. As you can see, there's boats all around. We're all going to have to swing together, and I don't know how much scope everyone's got out. If I've got roughly the same, and then we'll all swing roughly the same. And then on the other side, I have all the ferries coming in and town quay there. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to drag, I'm dug right in, so it's all good. And it's a beautiful evening now. So that's most of the Classics fleet over there, look.
I could till a few minutes ago.
Here's sea shanties coming from the quay up there. So I've tidied up the boat. I now need to tidy up myself a little bit and maybe put some long trousers on, dry out the dinghy, and then I'm going to go in search of a beer whilst keeping an eye on the boat. See, look, we've all swung around now. Look. Not quite sure what's going on, but we're all swinging roughly the same, so that's a good thing. Very good thing.
Yes, right.
Hello, I'm the great prince.
Bada bang!